I'm ready. You got that swag. You got that salt, that sell it. Free money. Cash them out, we bailing. Saw my teacher, I was the same student fella. Now I got a lawyer. Straight cash, no settlement. I'm out my element. Out my element. My the same. Don't need no clout, no fame.
No clout.
Bought the game. All brand new chain. I swear the lane. Call the group the gang.
Gang.
Whip that thing.
Whip it.
This shit give me. Ooh, yeah. Them boys fool you trying to do it. Bring the. Don't want no. They pull up with that. It's times three. This how it go. Park $1 million at the. We gon' make on eat that until we go.
Eat it up.
Rich straight to the top floor.
Top.
More PJs than
PJs.
Rich like water, go to Cabo.
Splash.
Cash in the walls, hollow.
Cash.
Your money too small, micro. Hunch up on the call, got a. Yeah. Superstars. Superstars out.
Hey.
Brand new cars.
Skirt. Yeah.
We by the bar now.
Woo.
Swaying doors now. Now.
Smash.
Chats and goals.
Tats.
Rock the shows.
Yeah.
Big bang rolls.
Cash.
Now she go.
Go.
For the team.
Ooh.
Now she don't ski.
Splash.
Think about posting her on the ground. Man, the leader.
Deleted.
Whole gang in the field. We don't do bleachers.
Gang.
Think about posting her on the ground. Man, the leader.
Deleted.
Whole gang in the field. We don't do bleachers.
Yeah. Ice the gang.
Ice.
Had to ice the gang.
Ice.
So much ice.
Too much.
Had to ice the lane.
Whew.
Freeze the dud,
freeze.
Had to freeze the lane,
freeze.
Camera phone,
flash.
Turn your lights off. We been on. Came from my block and growed up. Guess I'm homegrown. Well known. That is my cologne. I put my wrist inside the freezer, came out froze.
Ice.
I put my heart inside, cause I was chose.
Heart chose.
I put my heart inside, and only God knows.
God knew.
Get a Kleenex for that baby, but this no.
And coach, we are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome here in New Orleans. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
Ohio!
They go play action here on first down. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll make it a second down. Looking to throw on second down. Watkins. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. 8 yards on the ground there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 2.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle. And oftentimes, we call them a hybrid. Combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he will be marked down inside of New Orleans 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Big completion there on third and short. Keeps their opening drive alive.
Not only alive, but plenty of possibilities now. First and goal, and you know me, I'm a big advocate. If you're going to throw the ball, throw it early in the down and distance count.
A first red zone opportunity for the Panthers thus far. They've got a first and goal to go at the 7. Now a first carry for their fullback. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal.
Good solid gain on first down. About what you'd expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
From the 2 now, second and goal. Looking to throw, Watkins. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
The crowd here in the dome making things difficult. Third and goal.
Ohio! Ohio!
Operating from the gun. Watkins. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. And his kick is indeed good. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. So a nice opening drive on the road. You get the 3 points. Part of you wonders if that might hurt them later not getting into the end zone.
Well, the good thing is, still first quarter, and they did come out of it with points. In a sense, they could look at it positively and say, hey, we set the pace in this one. I think that's how they'll go about it.
First carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? They responded to the challenge.
And they'll go on the ground. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
To throw on 2nd down. Watkins. Henry's got it out on the left side. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. His first catch, good for 14 there and a 1st down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations. But a guy of his size, can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a 1st down.
He'll get it up the middle, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A pickup of four on first down. It'll be second and goal. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Back to throw. Watkins. That is incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. The crowd here in the Dome making things difficult. Third and goal.
Ohio! Ohio!
From the gun, Watkins. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Throw now on second and 10. He's going to float this one deep and got his man complete past the 20. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. The penalty, it's Kamara. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. It's a gain of five, but they're still deep in a hole. 15 yards still to go on third down. Back to throw here. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
And on this play, the read for the quarterback was the defensive end, and he was totally focused on the quarterback. He should have given it off inside to the running back. Instead, he kept it and ended up taking a loss on the play.
Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. They give him a gain of 38.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell. And this one will be brought back to the 22. He has just been a load for opposing offenses to account for. Now 8 interceptions on the year.
I love that number because I always think of center field. You know, when I hear 8, because that's the position you write in the scorecard in baseball. And what do good center fielders do? Take away all the alleys, right? They range deep and make a whole lot of great catches.
They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll take us to the end of the first quarter. They've got a 2nd and 9 to start things out. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
They'll look to throw. Looking here for Smith downfield. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A gain of 32 that time.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on 1st and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This throw is going to be incomplete. Thomas, the intended target, and now it's 2nd down.
Well, sometimes those cliches really come true, don't they? When they talk about it takes all 11 to play good defense. We've seen that in this ball game. I think the secondary has to be singled out, though. They are in the presence of every receiver whenever the ball's thrown, and this one, they help force another incompletion.
On 2nd down, Kamara. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
That 2nd down play call was not to pick up the 1st down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable 3rd down because they had the incompletion on 1st down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They'll drop the throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
All right, I need you to check my eyes here. This entire unit defensively, I think, has looked really strong in the first half, especially in the secondary. They've been cohesive, fast to the football. We just saw another example arriving there to help knock that one away.
And Lutz's kick is good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So they do get 3 points, but that's now 3 drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. 1st down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. On 1st down, they'll run it on the draw play. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air.
But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They picked up another first down with that run.
Looking to throw. Watkins looking for the out route, and he's got more. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Back to throw. Watkins.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Looking to throw. Watkins. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. And keep your eye on that man. Four sacks last week, one there here in the second quarter. He can be so disruptive.
So what was he doing in the first quarter? What was going on?
Took a nap.
I think he tried to lull him to sleep a little bit. Like, yeah, okay, maybe you've got me this week. No longer. And you know, with the four sacks last week, it's obvious he gets his in flurries.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
He'll look to throw. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
12 more yards there and another first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They'll look to throw here. Going left side here, and it's complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. This quarterback now, 5 out of 10, 50% throwing it. Not so hot, but he does have a first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Pressure comes in, he's brought down, it's a Panther sack. A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. We're back to New Orleans after this. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Detroit. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Only 3 yards on the pickup. They'll be left staring at a 3rd and 14.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Here we go now.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. The Panthers are going to take another timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches.
No. Patriot! Patriot! All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Back to throw. The quick slant caught. So give him the first down. 1st and goal after a pickup of 4, and the decision to go for it pays off.
I know a retirement ceremony is a rocking chair is often one of the major gifts, but don't give this guy one just yet. He may be plus 30, but my goodness, how about that effort?
Yeah, he's not that old. Hey, I'm on the wrong side of 32.
You okay?
And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. It's their quarterback. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Saints are back within a score. Lutz now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's going to wind up bringing this one inside the 45-yard line.
Now that's the kind of return that warms the heart of a special teams coach. He'll be pushing us next time, Brandon, to make sure his guys are introduced in the starting lineups. These guys have such an influence on every game. The unsung heroes, remember, they have their own meetings, their own practice time, heck, their own spot on the bench in order to be ready to play each and every week.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on 1st and 10.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. From left side, it's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a 1st and 10.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll throw now on the final play. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. We now proceed to the start of the second half. So we come upon halftime. Intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the 3rd quarter. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line.
All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56.
Now back to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Thomas. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Running with Kamara. Room to run past midfield. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected. But that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
The 20. Oh, some strong running. And he almost made it, but just short. Finally out of bounds, right down around the goal line. So close, couldn't get all the way in, knocking on the doorstep down to the one. Nevertheless, fantastic run.
Not only that, this is where you wave to your replacement, go back to the bench. No way, I'm not coming out of this game. I got it down to the 1 yard line. I want to carry it in.
We'll see if they reward him on. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great play there, hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Saints are able to cash in for 6. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's into the clear. The 40. 30, and it'll be a terrific return here as he gets it down all the way inside the 30.
That strong return has set them up nicely for this drive, and we all know the next score is going to have a major impact on this game.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Back to throw. Watkins finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and that's going to bring up a third down. Off the play fake. Watkins. His throw caught right around the 6. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Flex route! Flex route! Flex route! Flex route!
Looking to throw. Watkins eluding the pressure right. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
From the 2 now, 2nd and goal.
Flex route! Flex route!
Back to throw. Watkins. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DJ Moore, his second touchdown of the night. And his guys are able to strike for six.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They had gotten the lead with the opening drive touchdown in the third quarter. Now they relinquish that lead back. Could be in for an interesting second half.
It certainly appears that way, doesn't it? Almost turning into one of those pendulum games, right, where it swings back and forth, and who's going to make the play that changes that, but maybe it puts it on one side and keeps it there.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. A 10th carry for Kamara. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout as there's a Saints player down here on the field. While he gets attended to, we'll step aside. Now they'll run it on the toss. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 9 yards on the pick up there, and it keeps the drive alive. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Watch him now, Barney, Barney!
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. Nothing doing, barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish, holding that to a minimal gain?
Here we go now. Blue 90.
They'll set up a throw. Going up top. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Tre'Quan Smith, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints are able to cash in for six. So a one-handed grab in the end zone. Nothing much more rewarding than that for a guy catching it.
Not at all. And with what we just saw there, that type of a one-handed catch, what's next? Maybe they go up and almost Velcro with their jersey in the ball. That's about all that's left. That play, simply spectacular.
So a one-handed grab in the end zone, not much more impressive than that. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Ohio! Ohio!
Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Tackled there by Alex Anzalone.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Looking to throw on second down. Watkins. And his throw here is incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Panthers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Operating from the gun. Watkins. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. They'll try and strike this drive in the air. Looking long for Thomas. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against him offensively. And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And a sideline pass that's caught by Thomas. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
First down. Here's a run with Peterson. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. Lutz now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. It's a gain of 7, and it'll bring up a 2nd down. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. To throw on 2nd down. Watkins escaping the pressure right. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a 1st down.
They go play action here on 1st down. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Wow, between last week and this week, that's now 8 interceptions. 5 a week ago, now 3 here.
Well, he is so lucky that one of the defense coordinators I played for, a man named Ken Donahue, is not there right now. Because he saw that happen during his coaching career, and he grabbed a quarterback in the midst of a streak like this and said, tell you what, son, why don't you throw it to the defensive guys, and let's see if our receivers can intercept it.
Well, he's got to figure something out because the current formula is not working.
Nothing open downfield, and he had to get that one out in a hurry because he just knew he was about to take a big shot. Probably couldn't get his legs into the throw. Became an all-arm throw trying to check it down to his running back. Incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. A give. This is Kamara. And he'll be taken down at the 18. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Back now here live in New Orleans. The Saints on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 5.
Set! 3-19! 3-19!
He'll look to throw. And that's caught by Smith. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. Their fullback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Here we go now.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turned into a nice play.
They had the incomplete pass on 2nd down. Now they need a big play here, 3rd and 10. He'll drop to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Flush to his right. This complete to Henry over the middle. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
Decent start to the drive there. Of course, they need the touchdown, two-point conversion, and a field goal.
Yeah, those guys are into it. How about the guys on the sidelines? You see the coaches signaling, all the personnel groups up on the sideline, ready to go in and out of the game. They've got to condense their time now in order to try and get back into it.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Herrera. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First target, first catch, and a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On first down, Watkins. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and it's a second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Looking to throw on second down. Watkins, throw left side complete. It's Whitaker. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 15 yards through the air and a first down. Off play action, Watkins. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard. They'll look to throw again. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
The Panthers on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. Looking to throw. Watkins. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. The Saints say they have it, and they do. A little careless with the football, and he also had a fumble loss last week, didn't he?
He certainly did, and when I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember, traffic, turbulence, people around you, 2 hands. Get 2 hands on the ball. Grip it tight. I know it looks cool to have it in one hand, but put it away, tuck it away, because you've got to take care of the ball.
Detroit! Detroit!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. It's caught on the right side. It's Smith. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Give him a couple on the catch. It's 2nd and 8.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They'll try and run with their fullback. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Well, he tried to bounce it outside, but that's obviously not his game. He's too much of a straight line runner.
Yeah, him in the outer third of the field, not a recipe for success. That time a loss. The Saints on 3rd down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. They'll look to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And they pick up 25 as they convert on 3rd. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on 3rd down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Gun! Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. And they'll go with the ground attack here. And that one blown up quickly.
as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down.
What a nice read and play by the defensive tackle. Never bought the play action fake. Went right for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Carolina getting set to take the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, yeah. Because you're exactly
you
right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
A gain of six there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. From the gun, Watkins. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line.
I remember throughout my career here, and defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. To throw on third down, Watkins. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Whitaker. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A really nice gain of 25 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
To throw on second down, Watkins flushed out right, and he's going to drop this off to his fullback, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football, but sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And that will be incomplete. As time has run out on this football game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Saints,